Budweiser Copper Lager Gem Beam, and Astrophotography today on Shots with Shots. I am Yeager, your host of Shots of Shots, a show where I do some talking about these kind of shots that you drank, and then some talking about shots that involve cameras. So when Budweiser and Jim Beam decided to get together like all the cool kids are doing, myself included, and come up with a collab, this was the result that led to many shot and beer combos that almost sort of markets itself. The result also ended up with them shipping out this, what you see before you here, Budweiser Copper Lager Jim Beam. As the wind picks up here, I got a little bit more on the backstory of this collaboration between two pillars of the alcohol drinking community. It's brewed with two-row barley and aged on Jim Beam bourbon barrel staves to create a toasted oak aroma and nutty taste with caramel, rye, and vanilla notes. According to a press news release. To me, it just drinks pretty smooth. It was 6.2% alcohol by volume. You feel all right after a few. So I highly recommend it. Let's fast forward now to some nighttime astrophotography. Do I look sort of ominous with the light all like this? Besides the fact that I look like a complete and total joke with this light on, it is also really good to have a light like this on your head when you're out here at nighttime, as me and Renegade are right now, so that you don't trip and fall because it's night and it's tougher to see. Sounds simple enough, because it is. Just like astrophotography really is that simple too. So to start off with, we're gonna use the 500 rule. And that just basically means whatever the millimeters are, we'll divide by 500. With this camera, this Canon Rebel camera with the kit lens, that's right, you don't even have to use anything crazy new or crazy expensive to get night photo shots of the night sky. All you gotta do is take 500 divided by 24 in this case. And that is gonna be 20.83333333. You'll just round down, and that's gonna tell you to leave your shutter open for 20 seconds. Now the 500 rule, just like any rule, it can be broken. I've gotten results completely almost not paying the 500 rule any attention, but it's a good base to start off with, so definitely try it first, give it a shot. Set your camera to manual, set your focus to manual, so the camera isn't hunting the stars, trying to focus, or if you have anything in the foreground, background, it's focusing where you're gonna want it to focus. You can use a digital zoom in your camera if it's got one to do that. Your DSLR, your mirrorless camera, or mirrorless cameras out of a DSLR, because we haven't really figured out what we're really calling those yet in the photography community. Use it. If it's a little bit blurry, it's probably gonna be blurry. It could be too bright. Maybe up the shutter or decrease the shutter length a little bit too. That's another tip that I've found on doing this. Now I've tried to keep the white balance as basic as possible because I'm gonna normally adjust it in post, and I've got another video on the Carolina Photography page for that. Hop over there to see how I edit these night photos and some of the changes I do there. Basically, I just wanna shoot in raw so I can have way more latitude over these photo files. Take a look at these, see how they turn down again. I'm editing some over on our Carolina Photography channel. Hit that like button if you like and subscribe to never miss a shot from YeagerShots.com.